Hi friends, I am Shalini Tarwade. Let's start with concept of term belts, ropes and chain drives. Belts or ropes are used to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft by means of pulley which rotate at same speed or at different speed. Usually we have seen that power is transmitted from one shaft to another shaft by means of belts, ropes, chains and gears etc. Belts and ropes are used when the distance or the central distance between the driving and driven pulley is large. For smaller distance, we have generally seen that gears are preferred, which can be helical gear, spur gear, etc. Belts, ropes, chains are flexible types of connectors, that is, they can be easily bent or has flexibility in its nature. The amount of power transmitted by these belts or ropes depends upon following factors such as velocity of belt, tension under which the belt is placed on the pulley, arc of contact between belts and smaller pulley. The arc of contact of smaller pulley plays an important role upon power transmission. Conditions under which these belts are used. The shaft should be properly in line to ensure uniform tension across the belt selection. To obtain a uniform tension, the shaft should be placed, both driving and driven shaft should be placed in line. The pulley should not be too close in order that the arc of contact of smaller pulley must be as large as possible. The arc of contact we have to obtain should be as large as possible. The pulley not to be so far that cause the belt to weigh heavily on the shaft, thus increasing the frictional load on bearing. This increases, if the pulleys are too far away, that increases the frictional load on the bearing. A long belt tends to swing from the side to side, causing the belt to run out over the pulley. If the distance is large or if the belt is long, there will be observed the run out of the belt over the pulley, which in turn develops crook spots in the belt. The tight side of the belt should generally place at the bottom of arrangement so that the sag is present at loose side, which increases the arc of contact of smaller pulley. In order to obtain the good results, flat belts, the maximum distance between the driving and driven shaft should not exceed 10 meters and the minimum should not be less than 3.5 times the diameter of larger pulley. The central distance between the shaft of driven pulley and shaft of driving pulley should not exceed 10 meters. When we are using the flat belts, then we can obtain the good result. Selection of belt. The important factors that should be considered while selecting belt drive are speed of driving and driven shafts. Generally, the speed driving and driven shaft generally can operate at same speed as well as they can operate at different speed. Speed reduction ratio, power to be transmitted. Power to be transmitted is an important factor while considering the selection of belt. If we want to transmit the power up to 10 meter per second, we can use light belt drives. If you want, generally, which is observed in agricultural field, if you want to transmit power up from 10 meter per second to 22 meter per second, we can use middle belt drives. If you want to transmit the power from about 22 meter per second, we generally in machine tools we can use heavy belt drives. Central distance between the shaft, as I have said, if we are using flat belt drives, the central distance between the driving shaft and the driven shaft should not exceed 10 meters. Positive drive requirement, shaft layout, space available, service conditions. Types of belt drive. Light drives. Belt drives are generally used when we want to transmit small amount of power up to 10 meter per second, generally observed in small machine tools or in tool shop or in agricultural machines etc. Middle belt drives are used when we want to transmit medial amount of power up to from 10 meter per second to 22 meter per second, generally observed in machine tools. Heavy drives. These drives are used when you want to transmit power up to about 22 meter per second, generally observed in compressor, generator, etc. Types of belts: flat belt, V belt, and circular belt. In flat belts is mostly observed in factories, workshop, where we want to transmit medium or small amount of power from one pulley to another. These two pulleys should not be placed more than 10 to 8 meters apart from each other. Then we can obtain the good result of flat belt. V belt is mostly used in factories or workshop where we can to transmit moderate amount of power. We generally observe in this V belt, we generally observe that both driving pulley or driven pulley are not placed very much apart from each other. They are generally very close to each other. Third one, circular belt or rope. Circular belt or rope is most generally used in factories and workshop where greater amount of power is to be transmitted from driving shaft to driven shaft. Generally, these ropes are observed in large scale industries. If you have to transmit huge amount of power, then single belt may not be sufficient. In this case, we use number of V belts or circular belts, which has large number of grooves. This belt in each groove is provided to transmit the required amount of power from one to another pulley. Open belt drive. Open belt drive. The open belt drive is used in shaft arrangement when the shafts are arranged in parallel and rotating in same direction. If both are rotating in clockwise or if both are rotating in anti-clockwise. In this case, if driver A pulls the belt from one side, that is lower side, as we observe RQ, and delivers it to another side, that is upper side, as seen in figure LM, the tension in lower belt will be more than the tension in upper belt. The lower belt is known as tight side, whereas the upper side, which has less tension, is called as slack side. Crossed or twist belt drive. Crossed or twist belt drive is generally used when both shafts are arranged parallel but rotating in anti-clockwise direction, one rotating in clockwise and another rotating in anti-clockwise. In diagram, in this case, the driver pulls the belt from one side, that is if seen in figure RQ, and deliver it to other side, that is LM. Thus, the tension in belt RQ will be more than the belt LM. The belt RQ is known as tight side, whereas belt LM, which has less tension, is known as slack side. A little consideration will show that a point where the belt crosses, that is both crossing each other, rubs against each other, and there will be excessive wear and tear of belt. In order to avoid this, the shaft should be placed away from each other, that is maximum distance of both should be 22B, where B is width of belt. If B is width of belt, 22B, they should be apart from each other. Quarter turn belt drive. In this drive, this is also known as right angle drive. Both shafts are arranged at right angle to each other. Driving and driven pulley is rotating in definite direction. In order to avoid the belt from leaving the pulley or slipping over the pulley, the width of the face of pulley should be greater than 1.4 width of belt. If the width of belt is P, then the width of face of pulley should be greater or equal to 1.4P. In this case, the pulley can not be arranged in reverse motion if reverse motion is deserved. When it is deserved to transmit the motion from one shaft to several shaft, all are arranged in parallel direction. यू।